Bing.
Mike Myers and Cameron Diaz joining us together from Shrek, the final chapter. Why does it say sometimes the final chapter and then some places forever after?
We're in the acting department of DreamWorks.
We're not with the marketing.
We're not the marketing people.
What do you think about it being the last one? Are you sad to see it go?
I'm getting more and more sad. Am I supposed to put my Yeah, because your mouth is completely.
You know
like,
why? It makes me sound taller.
Is that what it is? You're looking taller.
I'm kissing the mic right now.
That's great.
I am, and the more we talk about it, the sadder I get, honestly. Mm-hmm. I just can't even believe this. These characters have been a constant in our life for the last 10 years, and there's nothing that we have. I don't have any other character. I do a film, I play a character for 3-4 months, and then it's over, and I don't ever see them again. I won't even watch the movie ever again. And these characters, there's been this comfort that I didn't realize that I had. Knowing that for 2 years I would be visiting them, every few months to get to see, check in with them, see what story we're telling together, and then come back to it another in a couple of years. So it's kind of bittersweet.
It's obviously evolved to be a mega hit here in the U.S. and around the world. What was the pitch when you first heard, here's a movie called Shrek? Mm-hmm. What was the idea?
Well, Jeffrey, I was at the, of course, the premiere of Saving Private Ryan.
where this came up.
I was like devastated at the end of it. I was like emotionally spent, you know, and Jeffrey said, would you ever want to do an animation movie? I was like, yeah, whatever you want me to do right now, I'm happy. He said, it's a movie, it's called Shrek, and I thought it was the worst title in the world. Mm-hmm. And I literally said, is that going to be the final title? He was like, yes. And it's been a great experience. I am sad as well, but I also think it's really elegant to do what they do like on British TV, which is end a series, which I think is really smart.
Well, and in this film, I told Cameron when we were talking about it the other day that I actually teared up watching it. I mean, it's got a lot of heart, doesn't
it? This series has so much heart. I mean,
It's the love story. It's what we fell in love with Shrek and Fiona for in the first place, was their true love and them finding one another. It's not just we've seen in the last three films or the two in between, you know, the first and second, we saw their dedication and love to one another, and that they were building a life together and they were having a family together and their dedication in that way. But this one, because they're starting all over again, it's as they get to find their true love once again, just as they did in the first film. And that is what is so wonderful, that to get to watch again. You get to see them falling in love again all over.
Well, you do walk away, and for those who haven't seen it yet, you'll drive away from the theater and think to yourself, okay, don't take things in my life for granted.
Yes, absolutely.
Right? I mean, which we all do, but you remember sort of that you do that when you leave this movie thinking, okay, I got to enjoy what's in front of me. Right, Mike?
I enjoy taking things for granted. That's the interesting thing. I find this tremendous comfort. I'm actually not even kidding.
Really?
There is a little bit of joy in taking things for granted.
How do you mean?
It's... You know, it's
selfish and narcissistic
to that extent. Yes, yeah. Thank you. That was the word I was looking for. To be honest with you, I'm just blown away by Cameron's voice on the radio.
Isn't it great? Really?
Yeah, it's like when pretty girls do radio. It's crazy.
Introduce some Justin Bieber or something.
I know. It's just my feeling is. I'm like all of a sudden.
It's the microphone. It's,
you know, Cam is a broadcaster all of a sudden. It's like
I'm watching what Ryan's doing. I'm just emulating him.
Yeah, I get close to the mic because I don't have as much girth behind me. And you know,
there's enough girth in front of you. That's why.
Wow, I'm super uncomfortable. I, for one, I don't know if you guys know, I'm actually Canadian, and we can't handle this stuff.
You can't deal with this.
No, God, no.
But so you do have complete separation from our world here, don't you, in Hollywood?
Oh, to what extent?
I mean, he lives in New York.
But you'd come in to do this in Hollywood, and you don't hang out here in this world.
I like it. I love New York, and
You said earlier when we were doing something else, you said you like being a person.
I like being a person, yeah.
How do you, because it's tough to be a person at the level of stardom that you both have. How do you do that?
Well, there's a little bit of a funhouse mirror reflection of your life being a public person. And, you know, it is kind of the fine print of acting, the whole celebrity thing. But I mean, I don't unenjoy it, you know. I'm actually a site-specific introvert, you know. Mm-hmm. I'm mostly introverted, more a site-specific extrovert. And mm-hmm. when I have to be extroverted, I can be. But for the most part, I'm really quiet and shy. So it's an odd experience, but I don't have any judgment. I lived out here in Los Angeles for a long time, and I really enjoyed it. Mm-hmm. I just happen to love walking around, and I love New York.
New York is so wonderful because you really can blend in mm-hmm. to New York, and the people there. People, Hollywood is where people come to see movie stars and celebrities. So when you're on the street in Hollywood now, it wasn't this way before. I used to live in Hollywood because it was a place that I could be, and nobody cared that I was an actress. Mm-hmm. But now we've really have a thriving tourism here in Hollywood. It's really they've really bumped it up with Hollywood Boulevard and Hollywood and Vine, and it's really become a sort of where people come to see movie stars. And so with that being said, you can't really be in Hollywood as an actor and have your anonymity. You have your laid out there, sort of, the spotlight's on you at all times. But in New York, you just blend. You can just walk on the street and nobody looks at you. Nobody, and when people do see you, they just go, hey, hey, Cameron, hey, Mike, have a great.
Oh, they recognize you.
Oh, yeah. And, okay. And all they say is, hey, what's they just want to say hi. And hey, have a great day. And you say, have a great day back. And they're happy with that. It's a different thing here with the tourism because people are coming here to get a piece of it. So they want a piece mm-hmm. of you. In New York, they don't want a piece of you. They just want to say hi.
Well, you were saying earlier you escaped recently, about, I don't know, the elephant story. I thought that was a joke at first when you were talking about riding an elephant bareback with a tank top.
Yeah.
It sounded...
What was really great was what happened before that. I was bathing the elephant in a river before that. He was laying down in the river and I was climbing on top of it, bathing
I'm guessing
it.
This wasn't at LA Live.
Yeah. This is in Nepal.
Ah.
And then the elephant got up and there was a wild bull elephant across the river, and we had the females, and what he does, the wild bull does, is he comes and he takes the females from the people and takes them off
face.
Across the river. So we
I'm
had
not
to
comfortable
get
with this.
Really?
I was just going to say I play ice hockey, but I was hoping that's equally as exotic, but it really isn't.
It's not.
I can't.
No.
So we
had to get on the elephant. I was on the back of the elephant. I happened to be on the top on the elephant, and totally bareback, no shoes on, my pants rolled up, and a tank top on, and it was sunset, and one of the trainers jumped up on the back with me and just took just sort of yeah with the elephant, and it went into a full-on run, not a trot,
I'm afraid,
but like a full-on run. And an elephant, if you think of its stride, how long its legs are, the distance that was covered within seconds. We were running, and I'm running towards these hills, and the sun is setting, and I'm in full gallop on this elephant, and I'm just screaming with joy, laughing, like, this is my life. I have the most amazing life. I
can't remember. That's what it is to be a celebrity.
That's what it's like. I was getting,
most of the time.
We're that happy on a pre-core.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations on the final Shrek, and thank you guys for coming
thank
by. It's great
you.
To see both of
you.
Cameron Diaz. Appreciate
thank
it.
Thank you very much.
Ryan. Ryan. Thanks for lending your voice to Shrek Forever After.
Pivotal, wasn't it?
Yes, amazing. You were amazing.
I didn't let you down?
You were amazing.
I was amazing. Do the roar!